So what are you doing in Texas?
Wait, I'll show you. So here's where I'm going. Uh-huh. So here's the lake. But then look, when I do this, you can see half the lake is missing.
Huh?
Lake? No lake. Lake? No lake.
What's going on there?
It's Giant Salvinia.
What is that?
Giant Salvinia could be one of the very worst things that's ever happened to us as a species. It's a monster.
And this time of year, the beautiful lakes that dot the American countryside, the lakes that should be filled with swimmers normally, are filled with something else. It's a nasty problem, killing life in the water.
Giant Salvinia is the world's worst aquatic weed. So Caddo Lake has long had invasive species and vegetation problems, but never have we seen something so aggressively invasive as Salvinia?
So Giant Salvinia is a floating aquatic fern. It's from South America, and it, you know, it doesn't belong here. That's why it's invasive.
It floats anywhere. You take one little piece, 2 inches in diameter, in only weeks, it covers up acres.
It just replicates and replicates and replicates so quickly. So it's just like one of those horror movies, like, you know, wake up in the middle of the night and you're covered with this plant.
Pretty much every place you went, there were thousands of acres of Giant Salvinia just covering the lake.
You know, and it, when it runs out of room to grow out, it starts piling on top of itself.
One of the people down at Johnson's Ranch took a picture of a raccoon walking across it from one side of the bayou all the way to the other. So that's how dense and thick it is. You know, it supports the weight of a 15-pound raccoon.
How many fish did we catch today?
We kept 32 crappie and one bream.
That's the colorful one.
Yeah, the colorful one. When it was really bad, we couldn't fish because you couldn't get your hook and hook in the water. 2 miles on the lake, straight up and down the channel anywhere, it was just covered with salvinia. It looked like a tennis court or a football field, just grass, green.
So do you still get out on the lake?
Oh, yes. I hadn't fished as much this year. I came down here one day, and that's all you see were green. People were having a really problem fishing because you couldn't get out here.
Caddo Lake lies in the extreme northwest corner of Louisiana and northeast Texas, perfectly divided right down the middle by the state line. There are almost 20 threatened or listed species that call Caddo Lake home.
It's actually the only natural lake in Texas, which is a pretty neat distinction. It's been around a long time.
Nature is very fine-tuned. You know, when you bring in Giant Salvinia, it does so much to the lake. You've taken away the oxygen. You know, if you are a turtle and there's an opening and you fall in that opening and then the wind blows and then that Salvinia covers it back up, suddenly there's no place. And sometimes the mats can get a foot thick or more. So where is it going to come back up?
There's been a lot of stories about how it got here.
One of the things that I've read is that it was a decorative aquarium plant and somebody dumped it into the water system.
The story I heard that it came from someone else's boat from a lake down in Florida somewhere.
I really don't have any idea of how it got here. The lake is weird. I don't believe it was brought in from anywhere. It's God's waters. He put in it what he wanted.
Somebody compared it to having a friend with cancer, that they love Caddo Lake, and to see it each day just growing and growing and growing. We started to realize that it wasn't something like a tumor that you could go in and cut it out. We're going to be faced with managing Giant Salvinia. It's going to be with us.
I don't want to see the lake lose its beauty because of the Salvinia. We have tried our ever-loving best to slow it down.
You know, I've tried everything myself, everything from like a blowtorch, you know, trying to bury it, pulverize it, you know, put it in a giant blender. It comes right back.
You're looking at an act of desperation, a two-mile fence spanning Caddo Lake in northeast Texas, a last-ditch effort to stop an invasion.
When we first found it, we built a fence across the lake to try to keep it out of here. First time high water came in, it washed some of the fence up, and so our first attempt at controlling it went south.
We're using both herbicides to spray on the plant, to kill the plant, and the giant Salvinia weevil, which is a insect from Brazil, where the giant Salvinia is native.
We went to check out the greenhouse. We couldn't see any of the weevils, but
No, they're really hard to find. Like, they're kind of wild-looking things. Yeah. They have a great big, long probe, and they're kind of weird-looking, but they're only about the size of a flea.
Yeah.
These weevils only eat Salvinia, and they can only reproduce in Salvinia. They raise these Salvinia weevils so that they can go put them out in the lake in hopes that the weevils will multiply and damage it to the point where it dies and sinks to the bottom.
There is a living, breathing laboratory in our back door. People who will keep tinkering, if you will, and looking at other methods to try to solve this issue.
The lake means everything. I mean, I was born and raised here again, and I just want to see the lake being taken care of.
People ask me about, well, where are you going on vacation? Well, nowhere. I mean, where else could I go that would look like this?
When you get out there, you just feel like you've gone back in time, you know, and it's a swamp, but there's beauty there, and it's unique and special, and so it needs to be protected. So, does that make sense?
There's only a certain point at which a system can function, and then it may change into a different system, but it won't be the one that you knew. So we're just fighting to preserve what we've all enjoyed for the next generation.
This one piece is what I'm saying cover 23 acres. 23 acres. See what we're dealing with here? This is a beast. This is a bad one.
You know you're going to be animated, right?
I'm going to be a cartoon character?
Yeah.
Well, okay.